effect of that roughness. That is very important, that how the pipe surface is. It is smooth or rough. So let us see what is the effect of roughness. In turbulent flow through pipe, rough pipe results in large friction factor than that with smooth pipe for given Reynolds number. For example, if we have a same Reynolds number flow, but in case one there is a smooth pipe and in case two there is a rough pipe, then in turbulent flow, rough pipe results in large friction factor than with smooth pipe for same Reynolds number. If a rough pipe is made smooth, if we are trying to make the rough pipe to smooth, the friction factor is reduced. But ultimately a stage will come when further smoothening of pipe does not reduce friction factor. Understand? If we made rough pipe too smooth, then friction factor is reducing. But up to a limit. Ultimately a stage will come when further smoothening of pipe does not reduce the friction factor. And that pipe is known as hydraulically smooth. The condition after which further smoothening of pipe does not reduce the friction factor is known as hydraulically smooth. Roughness parameter K is a length representing the magnitude of surface roughness. And a relative roughness is the ratio of roughness parameter K to the diameter of pipe D. That means relative roughness is the ratio of K by D. If we see a figure, it looks like this. See, here we have taken two examples of different roughness. The figure you see, in first figure you see the roughness is like this. And in second figure you see the roughness is like this. Then K is, see, the length of the roughness K. And diameter is D, then the ratio of K by D is the relative roughness. Roughness basically has no appreciable effect on friction factor for laminar flow. I have already told you for that hydraulically smooth for turbulent flow. Roughness has no appreciable effect on friction factor for laminar unless K is so large. That the measurement of the diameter becomes uncertain. So this is about the effect of roughness. Now let us see the friction factor chart. Now what is this friction factor chart and what is used for? Friction factor chart gives the relation between friction factor and Reynolds number for particular relative roughness. You can see the graph. In graph you can see here this is friction factor, here this is Reynolds number for different relative roughness. Friction factor chart is used to calculate friction factor. Remember that. And it gives a relation between friction factor F and Reynolds number NRE. So this is F, this is NRE and this is K by D. See, you can see there is a straight line here, slanting line here. This is for laminar flow. And after that, you can see the different curves. This is the different curves for different NRE. Fine. So, if I have the NRE value here, and these are the curves for different K by D value. So, NRE is this, K by D value you know, then exchange this to K by D value and you shift to here, you will get the value of friction factor F. So the friction factor chart shows the relation between F and NRE with reference to relative roughness. Fine, and it is used to calculate friction factor. this friction factor chart is very important while we have to calculate friction factor F graphically. Fine. Now let us see another topic, which is the friction loss from sudden enlargement. Now what is sudden enlargement? Sudden enlargement is when the fluid is flowing to one pipe and the area of the pipe is just increasing, suddenly increasing. It look like this. See, the pipe area is A1, fluid is flowing like this and the pipe area is increasing to A2. That means there is sudden increase or sudden enlargement in area. Here the fluid stream separates from the wall of the pipe, issues in the enlarged section as a jet, which then expands and consecutively fills the entire cross section of the larger pipe. Fine. It is nothing but there is a smaller pipe diameter and there is large pipe diameter, and the flow is passing through that system. When initially the pipe is of small diameter, and then it is increasing. That means there is increase or there is sudden enlargement. If there is sudden enlargement, then what is the friction loss? What is the effect on friction loss while there is sudden enlargement? The space between the expanding jet and the pipe wall is filled with eddies. You can see in the figure this. See. This shows the eddies. Fine. So the space between the expanding jet and the pipe wall is filled with eddies. That means this area. And large amount of friction is generated there. Large amount of friction is generated in eddies within that space. So the friction loss HFE. Friction loss for sudden enlargement is represented by H suffix FE. So, friction loss HFE from sudden expansion of cross section is proportional to velocity head of the fluid in the small conduit. Right? Friction loss HFE from sudden expansion is proportional to velocity head of the fluid in the small conduit. And it can be written as HFE is equal to KE V1 square by 2. In small pipe, we have taken assumption area as A1, velocity as V1. In large pipe, we have taken area as A2 and velocity as V2. So, HFE is equal to KE V1 square by 2, where KE is proportionality factor called expansion loss coefficient. KE is proportionality factor known as expansion loss coefficient. And V1 is average velocity in smaller conduit. Now, equation is derived based on continuity equation, steady flow of momentum balance equation and Bernoulli's equation. Now, if we apply continuity equation, steady flow of momentum balance equation and Bernoulli's equation for part 1 and part 2, then we will reach to this equation. HFE is equal to V1 square by 2 into bracket 1 minus A1 by A2 whole square. And now if we compare this HFE equation and above HFE equation, then KE is equal to 1 minus A1 by A2 whole square. So this is about the friction loss in sudden enlargement. Right. We have the equation of HFE. HFE is friction loss due to sudden expansion. HFE is equal to V1 square by 2, 1 minus A1 by A2 whole square, where KE is equal to 1 minus A1 by A2 whole square. Similarly, now if there was sudden contraction in area, first case is for sudden expansion, now we will see second case for sudden contraction. If there was sudden contraction in area, then what is the friction loss? When cross-section area of pipe is suddenly reduced, fluid stream gets separated from the wall of the pipe and fluid jet is formed. See the figure. See here. First there is a large cross-section area and there is a small cross-section area. That means there is sudden contraction in area. This is my part 1, this is my part 2. Now in this, the space between the wall and the jet is filled with eddies. See, these are the eddies. You can see in the figure. The type of flow or the flow direction is like this. This is part 1, this is part 2. That means there is a sudden contraction. Now I have to derive equation for friction loss. The friction loss for sudden contraction of cross section, that is HFC, is proportional to the velocity head of the fluid in small conduit, same as above previous equation. And it can be written as HFC is equal to KC V2 square by 2. Here for small conduit we have taken 2 notation. Fine. So HFC is equal to KC V2 square by 2, where KC is proportionality factor called contraction loss coefficient. In that we have called expansion loss coefficient KE. Similarly, we have called KC as contraction loss coefficient. And V2 is average velocity in smaller conduit. Similar to previous derivation, equation is derived based on continuity equation, steady flow of momentum balance equation and Bernoulli's equation. We will reach to our equation and where KC is equal to 0.4, 1 minus A2 by A1. Fine. So, friction loss for sudden contraction HFC, we call it as HFC, friction loss for sudden contraction. HFC is equal to KC V2 square by 2. Here, for small conduit, we have taken notation number 2. So, V2 is velocity in small conduit. So, KC is proportionality factor called contraction loss coefficient and V2 is average velocity in smaller conduit. And after that, we will get the equation for KC. KC is 0.41 minus A2 by A1, similar to sudden expansion. Right? So, in today's session, we have seen the effect of roughness and friction losses in two cases. Friction losses in sudden expansion and friction losses in sudden contraction, HFE and HFC. And for that, we have seen contraction loss coefficient and expansion loss coefficient. So, that's all for today's session. I hope this is clear to everyone. Thank you.